Welcome to the VMware vSAN Support Insight demonstration. Hopefully today I'll be able to show you something that will remove a lot of the frustrations that you may have had over the past couple of years. Whenever you phone up VMware Support, the first question that you typically get is, can you please export the system logs? Now that by itself isn't challenging, but the size of these system logs can be challenging. Not just the downloading aspect of it, but also of course the uploading aspect of it to the FTP servers of the support team. So what we did is we created a new solution for the support team that will allow them to instantly provide you support if you have the customer experience improvement program enabled within vSphere. So if you have this enabled, this is what they end up seeing. They have this new interface and it actually instantly shows them what version you are running, how many VMs there are, what kind of performance you can expect, and also if anything has changed in the recent past. On top of that, if any alarms were triggered, they can simply click the alarm. And what you will now end up seeing is the KB article that is associated with this particular alarm and potentially how you can solve the problem. On top of that, they also have advanced performance diagnostics available. This is a Grafana interface and it actually shows all of the different metrics that are available for vSAN for all of the different processes that form vSAN. So whether that's LSOM or DOM, doesn't even matter. All of the information is available within this interface. On top of that, they can also see how the disks are behaving, what the flash devices are doing, and how the CPU and, for instance, memory is doing as well. All of the information available in this single interface for the support team. Now, of course, we didn't stop right there. We have a lot of additional information available for the support team around the configuration of vSAN, but also around the configuration of DRS and the configuration of HA. We've also included the information around potential advanced settings that may have been configured, but also, for instance, some of the information around fault domains. And we included the licensing aspect. So if there's anything wrong from a licensing perspective, the support team can also point this out. On top of that, all of the information that you have available, like the health check, is also available in this interface. So if a health check has failed, even if a cloud health check has failed, the support team will be able to see that and they can quickly point you as a customer to that particular health check that has failed. Capacity details are available, and if dedupe and compression are enabled, that is also available in this overview. And of course, they will be able to see how many disks each of the disk groups has. On top of that, we also have the VM properties available. Now, the one thing to point out here is that all of the information provided in this interface is anonymous. The only way the support team is actually able to see the names is when you as a customer provide them a key, and the key is represented within vCenter server as something called an obfuscation map. So when you provide them that map, these random names will appear as normal names to the support team. The other cool thing is that the support team actually has the ability to go back in time. So when you phone them up and you mention you had an issue 14 hours ago, they can actually jump back in time to that particular point in time, and the data is loaded in the interface instantly. That by itself, I think, is already a huge benefit. So if you feel that this is very useful for you as a customer, please enable a customer experience improvement program. And it's very easy to do. You simply go to the vSphere client. You go to the administration tab of the vCenter server, and then you click on deployment, customer experience improvement program, and you simply click join. So join now, and thanks for watching.